Hello, friend. My name is Rasmus Grønfeldt Winther. I am a philosopher of science, explorer, and diver. I love nature. I love the world. I am good friends with Pablo Carlos Budassi, who made this amazing, I want to repeat, amazing poster that you might have right in front of you right now, called Nature Timespiral. I'm going to document, speak up the little words marking the different segments, the different stages, the different phenomena that emerge in the origin, history, and development of the universe from the Big Bang, the very beginning of time, space itself, and matter and energy, all the way to today, with our many species unfortunately dwindling due to human impact, and also the cognitive, conscious Homo sapiens species present today. We will start now. The Big Bang, inflation, CMB, Dark Age, all happens very quickly, the Big Bang. The first generation stars, the quasars peak. The earliest globular clusters, spiral galaxies, one form of galaxy. And the Andromeda galaxy, Milky Way spirals. This is, we're now zooming into our home, the Milky Way. Now, Pablo is writing many different stars that happen in our galaxy, Barnard star, Luyten star, Terzan 7, Ross 128. These are all in the Milky Way. Arcturus, Aldebaran, Gliese 581. Alpha Centauri, our closest star that we know to our system. Lalande 2185, Mira Tau Ceti, a beautiful one. There are three kinds of stuff. Dark energy overtakes gravity now. So the universe starts kind of slowing down. Primal star. There's also regular matter, primal supernova, molecular cloud. Protoplanetary disks, we now get close to our planet. The sun turns on when enough of the hydrogen and helium that was formed, especially hydrogen formed early on in the universe, comes to very close, which kind of triggers and shakes the sun into being lit. The planets form very early on, right after, very close to when the sun was triggered. Earth isn't Earth yet, but there's a Theia impact. The moon, Theia becomes the moon. Now we have life beginning, the last universal common ancestor. There's DNA, prokaryotic cells. We don't quite know yet whether it was an RNA world or a cellular world originally. Photosynthesis also evolves fairly early on in life, but doesn't really take over. Global oceans from very early on, from rain for thousands of years. We have tectonic plates which start taking shape as the crust cools. And now we have glaciation, we have supercontinents, we have all these geological forms and geological processes which happen. Pablo Carlos Budassi went from life to geology. He's still focusing on geology. There's a lot of meteorite impacts. The Earth has gone up and down with its glaciation. There is what's called an oxygen revolution around 2.4 billion years ago, when photosynthesis has really taken over. We have bacteriophages, bacterial viruses, which also evolve kind of as parasites to bacteria fairly early on. Orogenic events are about the formation of mountains, happens through continental drift. There's blue-green algae colonies, cyanobacteria, now photosynthesis gets focused into chloroplasts, which eventually through endosymbiosis also become part of larger collectives of cells, such as red algae, dinoflagellates, amoebas, the first, so to speak, protozoans. Maybe not exactly the first, but for purposes here, that's what we're showing. Paramecium, melancerillium, also single-celled protozoans. Sponges, perhaps the first metazoans with simple nerve nets. Now we get the Cambrian explosion with arthropods, fish. There's a bunch of life that ends up dying, that ends up going extinct in the Cambrian explosion. Crustaceans are also part of the Cambrian explosion. Now we have complex multicellular life, and we get reptiles, we get birds, we get cephalopods like octopi. Then we are now moving very quickly. Remember, most of life evolved in the oceans. 6/7 of life, of the time that life has evolved, happened in the oceans. Land evolution, relative recent. We have meteors falling down. This is what causes the dinosaur extinctions. Most other mass extinctions happen because of other events, climate change of various sorts. However, human accelerated climate change, which is where we have right now, happens about 60 times what most climate change has happened in the past. Please go to the link that you can find below to an article in my Modern Met on Pablo Carlos Budassi. I'm going to read two paragraphs from that very brief and beautifully informative article. Budassi created a visual system for the infographic. Every billion years is represented in a 90-degree angle of the spiral. Additional details about our recent 500 million years are represented in the last 90 degrees of the spiral. Combining the dazzling beauty of the galaxy with scenes familiar to us on Earth, the events include the emergence of cosmic structures, the birth of the solar system, glacial periods, and the evolution of the human species. Although visually complex, Budassi starts every graphic with a simple pencil drawing. Quote, then it's a week or two of research and discussion with my friend and teacher, Professor Rasmus Grønfeldt Winther, end quote. And yes, that's me. And then, Budassi continues, I assembled a final graphic as a collage of public domain textures and some original photos and illustrations, end quote. Please be inspired by Pablo Carlos Budassi's poster. And then go do your own writing, go do your own reading, go do your own sketching. There is nothing more interesting, perhaps one of the last great adventures, than to learn about our beautiful world and universe, inside of us, around us on Earth, and out even as we seek out into space, and in the end, both space inside and outside. Thank you, friend. Be well.